Hello everyone! Welcome to What's What, a channel all about electricity. Today, we are going to show you some super uses of the almighty superconductor. Yoo-hoo! And if you want a little background on these puppies, check out our episode from season 1. Now, let's expand on what we have learned. Push the limit of science. Adapt to an ever-changing world. Create new innovative technologies. Overcome possible challenges. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe below. We know that when your standard conductor transmits electricity, its resistance generates heat due to Joule losses. And this increase in temperature can cause a lot of problems if the current exceeds the rated value. The plastic insulation could be damaged or melt, causing a breakdown. And with higher current intensity, its wires could melt too. One could get a bigger conductor to withstand such currents, but this route is heavy and expensive. How about a newer alternative? Compact, light, zero resistance, a cryostat to keep it cooled, able to transmit more electricity at a higher rate. Meet the superconductor. So how could we use one of these right here? Imagine a wind turbine. Its nacelle, including copper coils, weighs up to 600 tons. If superconductors were used to replace the copper coils, they could provide efficient magnets and generate just as much electricity, but without the extra weight. Sorry about that other conductor. We don't need it, right? To better understand the benefits of superconductors, one awesome factor to explore is power density. Power density is the ratio between generated power and the weight of its transporting device. For superconductors, the power density is very high. That's why superconductors are already used for submarine propulsion. And Navy vessels are just the beginning. Superconductors are also being considered in other electric applications. What a future! All thanks to this.
Frédéric?
That was nothing. Where were we? Ah, yes, cool ways these babies are used. Used in the sea and quite possible to be used in the sky. But did you know superconductors are used in the medical field too? That cylinder we enter when getting an MRI, it is technically a giant superconducting coil that generates a magnetic field around our bodies. But that's not all. Superconductors are also used for levitating trains. Yes, really? The world speed record for a train is 603 km per hour. And this train was powered by superconductivity. The levitation itself is obtained by the Meissner effect. The superconductor operates on the train chassis, and coils along the railway create a magnetic field. Some magnetic poles pull the train, while others push the train. But all poles work to send the train in one direction or another at unprecedented speeds. And to brake, the operator simply reverses the currents. Superconductors didn't just reinvent the wheel, they got rid of it. It may seem crazy, but no wheels, no friction, zero resistance. Superconductors are the base of particle accelerators, where intense magnetic fields cause elementary particles to spin in opposite directions at the speed of light. Physicists then analyze behavior of the particles to understand fundamentals of matter, radiations and interactions. For example, CERN in Geneva operates the Large Hadron Collider made of 27 kilometers of superconducting magnets in a circular tunnel. One of the world's greatest scientific achievements, with engineers from 100 different nations working together. These scientists are also pioneers of big data and World Wide Web. Another cool example is the tokamak, an experimental machine designed to test nuclear fusion without production of high-level and long-lived radioactive waste. It replicates a miniature artificial sun, sometimes achieving a temperature greater than 100 million Celsius degrees. No walls can hold such heat, so engineers called on superconductors for the rescue. Now, powerful magnetic fields are able to find a plasma in the shape of a torus, hence the name. Wow, that looks powerful. But before we wrap up, I want you to remember. Heat is generated due to Joule losses. Heat can sometimes damage standard conductors with excessive currents. Superconductors are an efficient alternative because of their power density and zero resistance. Superconductors boost the most ambitious scientific facilities. Today, superconductors are used to propel naval vessels, trains, and even MRIs. Tomorrow, they may even power airplanes. Countless other possibilities await to be discovered. And there are many other applications of superconductivity too, dating back to its discovery in 1911. We only covered a few, but just think, a whopping 6 Nobel Prizes in physics have been awarded to scientists in the superconductivity field. Who knows? If you explore the power of superconductivity, maybe one day, the award will be handed to you. That's it for this episode. Thanks for tuning in. Feel free to leave a comment, give us a like and share. And stay tuned!